Hello, my loves. Hello. Welcome to a new ASMR Reiki session. Today's session is all about our intuition. We will be reawakening, reconnecting to our intuition. So if that's something that you'd like, then make sure to keep watching. Also, we'll have a few louder sounds today, such as my rattle, and I'll also be tapping on things. So if you're watching this before going to bed, and you know that tapping will prevent you from falling asleep, click the playlist up above here, which has videos without any tapping or louder sounds. So let's get started. Today we'll be focusing on two different energy centers in your body: your third eye and your sacral, which is located just below your belly button. And we'll be focusing on those two centers because we have two different centers where intuition is located. The first one in our sacral is our gut feeling, as some like to refer to it. It's the part of our intuition that's very material, very based in this reality, in the sense that our gut feeling usually comes from the conscious processes of information that comes in through our senses. Things that have not come up to our conscious mind yet, but that we can sense. This kind of intuition is very much a feeling-based intuition. We can feel it in our body. And then you have your intuition located in your third eye, which is more so, I would say, of maybe not another dimension, but it's less material, less physical. It'll come in as a gentle whisper, a very soft thought, like, maybe I should call this person, maybe I should go here. It's not per se something that you sense in your body, but it's something that comes from the mind or is put into the mind but comes from a higher place. So this intuition is a knowing. The intuition or sacral is a feeling. I hope that makes sense. And our intuition really is just a side effect of the fact that we are connected to everything. It's because we are connected to everything that we're able to sense things. We're able to sense that maybe we should go there instead of there. We're able to sense if people are being truthful with us or not, because we are connected on a deeper level with them. We can feel into the energy of the things around us. So today we'll be working on opening those channels again. Intuition is not something we have to go out and search for. It's something that is innately programmed into who we are, how we came into this world. But because of how our modern society is set up, it's very easy to lose connection with our intuition. Because we really value logic, rationality, very amazing tools that we definitely don't want to discard. But there's another side of the coin, which is intuition, which we shouldn't forget about. So, we're going to reconnect with our intuition, release any shame or any negative beliefs that we have around our intuition and its irrationality. So, to start, we're going to cleanse the channels from your third eye and your sacral with my rattle. So, take a moment to arrive into your body. I'm really aware of the present moment, where you are, and how you feel. Take a moment to deepen your breath. Pulling the air deep into your lungs, allowing your chest to expand, and then bring all of your awareness to the sound of the rattle. Allow yourself to connect on a soul level with the sound, with its frequency. Feel it moving, clearing the energy. Releasing, unblocking any stagnation. Feel it vibrating in your third eye. Clearing up. Feel it connect in with your sacral, the energy center below your belly button. Allow the sound to become concentrated in that area of your body. Unblocking and removing any energy that is keeping you stagnant. Okay. So, before we go on and reactivate these two different centers of intuition, we need to let go of the beliefs that have been programmed into us that our intuition is untrustworthy, that our intuition is not valid, and that the only way to make good and right decisions in life is to follow your logic and your logic only. Our intuition is a great tool that we've been given, and actually many of our greatest scientists, such as Einstein, Nikola Tesla, relied on their intuition. for great inventions and discoveries. Logic can only take us so far because it's based on what we already know about our reality. There is so much more that is beyond our comprehension at this point in time. And that's the part that our intuition taps into. So let's collectively let go of the burden, of the shame that we have felt for following that nudge, that feeling that you have. And reconnect. Learn to trust that part of you again. So first, we are going to be removing the programming around our intuition that has blocked us from being able to connect with it and to trust it. And with anything in life, you don't have to force this trust in your intuition. You can take little baby steps and just try something small based on what your intuition tells you to do. Something that won't have a lot of consequences. And then see where it takes you. Build up a library of experiences in your mind of times that your intuition was right and that it did serve you. And then over time, your bond of trust with intuition will become stronger. So let's first pluck out those programs, and I'm just dropping them into this bowl with rose petals to clear them. We want to let go of this programming with love and with gentleness, because at some point in our life it did serve us. Go and try something different. Break out of the mold and see if there's more to life than what we've been told. If there's any specific beliefs around your intuition, hand them over to me so I can pluck them for you. You can do this by imagining the belief being pushed out of your body into the energy field around you, or I can simply pluck it out of your aura. So right now we're plucking any limiting beliefs around third eye, the center of knowing, of just knowing something without knowing where it comes from, knowing we should do something or go somewhere, because there is a voice in our head saying it would be a good idea. looks a lot better. Let's move to your sacral chakra, which is located, as I said, just below your belly button, about 3-4 fingers below. And we'll be plucking here as well. This part will be out of the frame as I'm plucking from your belly. So just imagine me plucking anything that's holding you back from connecting to your gut feeling. And as I'm plucking this, you can feel that center becoming lighter. You can feel the energy regaining its natural flow. Let's bring in some crystals to aid in the clearing and the reactivation. I pulled out this green onyx. This is a very mercurial crystal because it's multicolored and it has stripes, which is characteristic or an association with the planet Mercury, which is all about communication. And that's what we want to do. Reopen the lines of communication between that part of our body, that primal part of our body that just knows, that just feels when something is off, when something's about to happen. But also opening the lines of communication with our third eye. That knowing that comes from a higher place, a divine place. So allow yourself to connect with this green onyx. Feel it opening the energy lines between your third eye and your sacral chakra. Feel the energy flowing again. And any last bit of debris, of energetic debris from those channels is easily swooped up and removed as the streams start to flow again. Okay, let's reconnect those channels. Infusing the channels with the energy of the green onyx. Really good. So, our last two crystals for today are these fluorite octahedrons. Fluorite to me is all about clarity. And we want the messages from our intuition to come through clearly so that we know what to do. We know where to go, who to talk to, what to do. Now that we have cleared up the energetic channels, the energetic rivers in your body, we are going to make them crystal clear. Crystal clear. Crystal clear. So that's very easy to interpret our intuition. Until the water is completely clear, crystalline water flowing from your third eye to your sacral and back. Okay. So now we're going to activate and seal in this energy with some Reiki symbols, and I'll be using an oil to anoint those two centers of intuition. I have with me a little bottle with oil, which has a few essential oils in there and some flower petals. Placing a drop on my finger, starting with your third eye, chakra, really good, down to your sacral. So, last thing before I go, I will be applying some Reiki energy to both those centers to really seal in these structural changes that we've made, the clearing up, the energetic decluttering that we've done. And to reinvigorate, reinstate those parts of our energetic being. Moving down to your sacral. My hands are hovering just in front of your belly. I'm sending warm and loving Reiki energy towards your sacral center, sealing in the change that we've just made with love, allowing this to be your new reality, your new way of operating and being, reclaiming that part of ourselves. Alright. That was it for today's ASMR Reiki session. Again, and if you are asleep, sweet dreams. I hope that you wake up feeling refreshed and ready for another day on earth. If you are still awake and with me, you're welcome to leave a comment, drop a like. I will see you guys very soon.